All right. Oh, why the fuck did you bring? All right, we did it. Hi, welcome to Sidland. I'm out of shot, but that's okay. Go that way. Move that way. Hello, it's me. I'm over here. This is Brainstorm. This is Nace and whatever and Dweg, and we're going to be talking about CS for the LAN. So we're at the FBI Center in Sydney. We've got teams set up that way, over there, all of that, doing stuff. So that'll be fun. Everyone's laughing at us, but that's okay because they can do whatever they want. So I'm going to be jumping in with some games fairly soon. By the way, boys, I don't want to do all this talking. How are you going? Tell me.
I'm good, Tim. How are you?
I'll
get you to
kids. Anyone else?
Yeah, no, I'm pretty excited to see, obviously, three best of ones to start off, and then we get into the playoffs. So best of ones, always see unusual tactics. But it'll be interesting to see what's going on. So obviously, going to get on to Train for the first map. Vivi, what do you reckon we're going to see on Train?
A lot of pugging. Surprisingly, from not a pug map, but it's LAN with a lot of pug players, and it's going to be quite
interesting. This is the team with Zemp,
Zemp, Teal, and Apoc. You know, it's going to lend itself to some pretty
good. You do have good players, and you have like CGI and CGP level sort of like players, but it's still going to be like a lot of gunfights and just hope for the best after a rush out of A main or a rush out of Squeaky. It's quite Squeaky. SL.
Squeaky on Train, huh?
Yeah, man. It's the best.
Yeah,
I'm good at call-out.
It's always a big sort of puggy style on LAN, but it's always good to see on the T side that it's just so fast.
Right, so that aside, because there's not really too much analysis we can do about pug teams on LAN, we do have sponsors to thank. Shoutouts, of course, as you can see on your screen, to Gigabyte, Aorus, and Cooler Master for making this possible. We normally have like some sort of banner up, but we forgot about that today. So
we've got a nice wall.
We've got a wall, yeah. At least we have a brown wall, because like the previous LANs we've done, we've been in a room with like Hello Kitty on the wall. Yeah. So we don't have a Hello Kitty wall today.
That would be really nice, actually.
Yeah. It's like,
I just realized I should really turn game chat off because this is going to be a LAN. People
gonna
are going to chat words. So, all right, cool.
We can't have a rerun of CGA finals.
You say that. We definitely can. So, yeah, cool. Do we have any? I think we have some giveaways to do, guys. Pretty sure I have some motherboards and whatnot to give out to stream, something like that. Brendan, yes or no?
So no, keep it on.
All right, cool. We do have stuff to give away. It's gonna be pretty lax, but gonna be pretty chill. We'll have some stuff to give away somewhere. I think that's what all that stuff you're feeding. Can you pass me that bag?
If you don't give me it away, I'm taking it home.
I'm just going to be a disembodied hand over here who has things. So if there's anything like Last Land, one of these is MVP and one of these is for stream, but we have like...
MVP is normally motherboards.
Motherboards, there you go, there's a motherboard.
Beautiful.
There's some motherboards. Mouse pads for your teeth.
Always cool.
Yeah, so giving these things away at the end of today, and it's going to be going throughout the day. Streaming games and talking about stuff, playing some music and breaks and whatnot, so... Yeah.
That was not Tim, that was Brendan.
No, it's I'm forgetting how sensitive my mic is, and I'm not sure how much is in the background. So that's the one different thing, guys. As you can kind of tell, it might look like it, but we're not actually in a room here. We're out in the open. I would pick my camera up and show you, but it would look really dodged on the kind of bother.
I think it looked good.
Well, what we normally do is we normally have it in a room with the door closed. So I think now we're in an open space. We're going to get the crowd a little bit more than
we can yell at all
that
crowd.
The actual
like people that like
that's
the hundreds
true.
Of thousands of people that are all around now.
I mean,
is there betting
these
on these matches?
Get
we can like totally like change
two
viewers.
Two viewers.
Yeah.
Fabulous.
Yeah.
Well, to those two viewers, hello. Actually, if we do only have two, then I can just do this.
One of them's that PC.
And one of them's you. So we don't actually have any viewers.
Yeah.
Sweet. All right.
Yeah,
here's what we're going to do. Like, here's the venue. Ready? Oh, we're going on an adventure.
Oh.
There it is. Here's a lovely production man. Say hi, Brendan.
Hello.
Oh, that's Brendan. But there, over the back there is where all the teams are, and there's, like, players and my lamp. It's really bright. Yeah, so there's some guys over there. They're all part of the LAN over in that section there. And then over that way, well around the corner, is more Counter-Strike. So that's kind of... That's what we're doing, and wearing this
MC.
Little
there's
bit.
MC walking
oh, it's an MC.
Up.
Lovely admin. Now, can I get this back where it was?
Probably not.
Yeah. Look at that. Lock straight in. Fabulous.
So I think predictions, boys. Who do we think is going to take out the LAN?
You're a terrible human being for making everyone do predictions. By all means.
No, legitimately, there are some decent teams here, and I think it's going to be closely contested.
The Body Pillow Fan Club.
Who do we think is going to make
playoffs?
So we got two teams from each group.
If Tama and Geek don't make playoffs, then I'm going to laugh at them really hard.
So for Group A, we've got mid-CGA Fraggers, Outlaws, Aftermind, and Noxpiracy Limited Edition.
You'd have to say that Noxide definitely going to make
playoffs. Noxide are a team that have... like consistently won the previous done well two lands. All of these lands. You know, they've got some very good players in there. JD, Kenny, MC, Prodigy, just a bunch of experience of these kind of lands across the board.
Yeah, they're good at the
And then obviously they got Catalyst in for their team, which is the first time. So they had hats for one of them. And
they've had hats for
Vanilla, that's right.
They've had players cycling.
Yeah. They've had some rotation.
So they've always had the main four core, but they've always sort of like picked up a fifth for Lamb.
Yeah.
So last time it was Prodigy with the MVP at this event, and who was the last time before that?
Was it Malta that got it last time? No, it was Pex. Pex got the first time.
Pex and then it was Prodigy.
Pex and then Prod, I think.
What about this time? What do you think about most valid?
Well, having seen no games, I'm in a really good spot to make a very valid prediction.
No, it's fine. It's perfect.
Who's our second team to get out of Group A?
I don't know. I mean, the one thing I do want to point out about Outlaws is they're the only team with a full lineup here. So
they even flew people.
Second team out of Group A.
Huh? They flew people from Brisbane.
Yes, this is live. We're doing it.
And New Zealand, I heard that one of them
You're
came
not
from.
In camera.
Yeah, one of them came from New Zealand, two from
Neither
Brisbane,
am I, I'm just a voice.
Or maybe like one.
Hi, Brisbane, come over. Right. One of our admins wants to say hello. Hello, that's Zach. He's from Avant. He's cool, I guess.
We're doing
Killdeath
versus...
Killdeath
versus Mitch.
Mitch, M-I-C-H. Yeah, so spoilers doing that. That's... That's Group B.
That's going to be an exciting match.
That'll be fun.
That's
what I was saying before Dash went up to me. Outlaws is the only team with their full five here. They actually did fly into this land as well. They have players from, I think, Brisbane, Melbourne, and New Zealand, as well as a couple of Sydney.
I think you can't discount the pure experience that Aftermind have.
That's true.
They've got Nick,
I do like
coming in
as well.
Calling him old.
Nick, I just said Nick.
Cookie's there as well.
I do like that.
Nick's had a resurgence. He's been playing really well for Sif.
Oh, yeah, I can tweet we're live then.
I think out of all your teams, I don't have a thousand yet. There's always like one or two players that we can sort of shine to of being a star for it. So I think definitely like Zemp and Till, like.
For the match card, for sure.
For the past like two lands we've seen them play, they have really just been firebombing. Like, they have been fragging as hard as they can.
But then also, you can't discount the fact that you've got Exe in there, who was part of the Cronulla team
last time,
Apoc, a player that recently was playing for Masterminds.
They won CGI, didn't they, just recently?
Yeah, I think they did, yeah.
So,
I mean, he wasn't on the team.
And Major as well as their fifth, don't really know much about
I don't
him.
Know much about Major. And then they're going up against...
Is it Major, I believe, is on Aftermind.
Aftermind?
He's on Aftermind, but he's not playing with them at LAN.
Right.
What's out? Is it Sydney LAN, right?
Sydney LAN. And then Mitch. It's another exciting team.
Well,
Kingbit.
I mean,
Bass
that was...
Mist.
You could... Old Miven, really.
Basically Miven, but without Mizu or Pex.
Without the good players.
So a bit of a downgraded...
Bass counter.
Bass coming back, he hasn't really been active since getting kicked from Darktide.
Yeah.
He's been playing
on different teams, he just hasn't had a consistent
line.
As much as such as Darkseid. Darkseid were very strong with him, and then they kicked him, and then they got even stronger.
And now they've lost Goa now. So
it's kind of jumbled up when he's left.
Well, I mean that's a completely different Darkseid.
Yeah,
absolutely. So I think it's exciting to see him back. Mist is a player.
Nova. We haven't spoken
Nova,
about Nova.
Nova's here. Nova, the ex-Vox, ex-Chiefs player.
Ex-God.
Ex-God.
Even
ex-God.
James
Could
Barber.
Be ex-God.
Ex-God as in previously God, not Doja.
Sex-God.
But no, he's another player that was on top of the world, on top of Australia.
Back
on Chiefs, he was really a hot prospect.
I don't even think he's been subbing for any teams recently.
You're in the last slot of this match, so Blitz can't join.
I'm in spec.
Are you in spec?
Yeah.
It says the server's full.
So there's only 10 slots.
Did MC make it
11 slots?
Yeah, he probably made
it
10 slots.
I think he made
slot.
It 10 slot.
Alright. Cool.
We're probably not gonna be able to do that much.
All right. We'll sort that out.
Let's just do server 1 or 2 in the GeoTV.
Yeah. Let's do Noxide versus Aftermind.
Noxide versus Aftermind. All right.
So that means we won't be able to unless MC.
He's restarting server.
Oh,
that's
okay.
Fine. We're swapping.
No. He's already restarted. Let's do that one.
That's all right.
That's doing so much better.
It's fine. Let's finish my tweet.
You better tag us all.
I am. I'm running out of my characters.
You're running out.
I have 280 and I'm running out.
No, I don't have that.
The tagging's been
hit. You're taking.
I actually thought 280 was rolled out to everyone.
I didn't get it.
It has been.
I got. Yeah, it's rolled out to everyone.
You see that little circle thing?
No.
It changed from like the character limit or like the numbers counting up.
I think it is retarded.
When you tweet.
Yeah, it's a circle now. And then when you get to 20, it goes down again.
It's a circle. You see the circle?
Oh, yeah. Do I need to click it?
No, you just type. And then the circle will slowly fill up, and then when you get to the last 20, it changes to a number.
Oh, I actually didn't know that.
As you can see, Sydney LAN is
the most organized.
The most professional, most organized event.
Especially considering that Karath isn't even here and it's his LAN.
That was the creepiest thing I could see on camera, just coming just in.
I didn't realize I was going to be on camera, but
just
I did want to. I did want to.
You're used
to
being on camera,
so.
Tim. Come on. He just doesn't want to show up on the stage.
It's for
anyone that didn't watch Zen League yesterday, you're missing out.
Damn
that!
That's hot.
That.
Mm. CD, it's for charity.
Porn star.
How dare you?
Is there anything more we can talk about? We don't even know what game we're doing.
Yeah, no, we don't.
I'm pretty sure we're supposed to be doing the game 4 because they've restarted it now.
If we can get in,
like that's the preferable match. If not, right, we can do one or two.
Okay.
So it's gonna be on train.
Yeah, I don't know which one is supposed to join. I'll try this one. There's two server fours.
It's all a prank. Dust 2, that's not it.
No, it's since they restarted.
Yeah.
So they have to switch once again. It's definitely an interesting match because Killdeath, I think this is their third time here as well.
I can't wait to see Killdeath play.
Yeah, last time they
Why are you standing up?
Teams.
Because I was putting my phone away.
Also, the microphone blocks Drake's mouth.
Does it?
Yeah, you just
I can't put it down anymore because I'm the boom. That's why I can move it like there.
That's good.
Yeah. That's good. I just have. Yeah, okay.
I think.
Why am I? I don't want to be here. I want
to
be here.
To me, Killdeath. Oh, okay.
Alright, we're going to train.
Killdeath are going to play a lot like. What are they? Noxpiracy?
Noxpiracy, yeah.
Noxpiracy. The way Noxpiracy and that Noxide team especially played was extremely aggressive. Running as a five-man unit onto those bomb sites, just...
Ah, stop joining the team, I don't want to be here.
The death train.
Okay.
Strategy.
Yeah.
Need to...
Yeah, get that out of there.
Need to not have player voice in here.
Unless we want to hear voices.
I think we
can hear someone raging.
Mostly you.
I am offended, I'm not tagged in this.
Wow.
Your production, sorry, whoa.
That's toxic. Oh, there's a lot of people.
There's a lot of people in 50. Okay, so we should be live soon, hopefully, doing stuff.
We'll be getting into this game. Looks like, what?
Blitz is still in the FM Steam group. Why is there so many people in the... Oh, bots. Right.
Yeah, so you mean Killdeath?
How dare you?
Why is all these bots?
Because they haven't fixed that.
Killdeath has Joe Ivan. I don't know.
Wait, I can't. This
is
an old stream, is it?
We can probably swap over to the game now, right?
No, we can't. I'm doing icon things.
Okay.
I wanna...
Yeah, preferably don't show that on stream.
Yeah.
That's like the most important thing you can't show.
Oh, is that shared on stream?
Haha, Brandon. Funny.
DDoS.
Will the bots get kicked?
DDoS LAN.
God.
Yep.
Hey, there we go. Are you ready to observe Tim Brainstorm Duck?
Sure. This will be a good time. Getting notifications. Alright, because everyone's going to be Yeah, you know, it's going to be fun. I think, yeah, we have no bots. We have a clear console. Oh, it's all lovely. Oh, man.
Beautiful stuff. Beautiful
Still
stuff.
Chatting console. I'm just going to keep clearing this. Oh, I didn't type it right. Oh, it's all over. Okay.
Can you can you open up the menu, the map?
The map.
Draw some pictures.
Maybe.
Do you want me to...
You're just drawing circles right
Is it right with the blue?
Yeah, I can also change colours into these ones.
How did you get that?
Z and X.
I didn't know that was a thing.
I need to get it back to the normal colours.
Hey Tim, did you know that you're able to not draw circles? You can draw other things as well.
Draw a perfect circle.
There we go, that's some lines.
You can draw team names, like when they stuff up.
This is the heartbeat of the players in this server when they lose.
Flatlining.
Yep. Yeah.
I frown.
Cool. Knife round. This doesn't have a knife. Knife first. I'm actually not gonna do this. I don't care.
They're gonna lose because Ronaldo doesn't have a knife.
No. You know what I want to see? I want to see if Body Pillow Fan Club can win knife rounds because we never can online. Like we've won maybe 2 out of the last 8 we've played.
When you say we,
I coach
it's
that.
Just Tom.
And yeah, well, was geek. That's true. Anyway, I'm blaming Tom. He's like, I'm gonna bring that whole team down, my friend. He's not doing fine. Anyway, okay, so game number one, Group A, I think. No, it is Group B, actually. No?
This is Group B.
Yes, okay. So, Kildaz versus Mitch.
Jeez, I got excited about a knife round.
Yeah, we're on GoTV, so don't react to player reactions, because we're behind. Who's casting this? You two?
Yeah,
we'll do this. Okay, cool. So, Dweg, and I'm going to call you whatever, because you have V's in your name and you suck. Those two are going to do the thing. Cool, go.
Alright, so obviously you're going to move on to Train, which is going to be the first map.
Turn them. We good?
Okay. Yeah. Done. Perfect. Fabulous.
So, jumping into the first match of Sydney LAN so far. So, obviously, we've got Killdeath and... it's not Miven, it's...
Mitch.
It's Mitch now. It's Miven slash other players.
Couple of others.
Yeah, there's no Malta.
So, obviously... Counter-Terrorists, they're going to start off with the Killdeath lineup, and armor coming across the board on the Terrorists, and on the other side, there's going to be actually no utility or no kits whatsoever. But the Terrorists, they're looking like they're going to get some aggression towards these brown halls. As so far, it's going to be XE first point of contact with this USP. He's going to spot out one and instantly get taken down by Blitz. So the Terrorists are now just going to make their way towards this B bomb site, and the CTs, they're slowly rotating in.
Now there's no one left to defend against that B bomb site, but Zep moves in, takes the first kill against the Far Squad, comes in with the second kill, Blitz takes that frag with the APOC. It's going to be that point man, and wow, it's actually only Cristiano left, and now he's taken down by Mist. That's a great round from the Terrorists. They're already screaming.
I don't think they're
already screaming.
Up, but there's a lot of going on.
Round one's over, and there's already screaming. That's always a good sign.
Counter-Terrorists really just trying
wait,
to hold
on. Brandon, can you go to Carl's camera for a second?
Oh, you gotta
go offline. Thanks, I gotta
just a quick offline.
I forget how to use Steam. Okay.
There it is.
Okay, we're good, go. Back to game.
Perfect.
We did it.
Counter-Terrorists obviously forcing straight back into this. Cristiano, once again, on the scout. We've seen it using many times in the past lands. Sees if he can find anything. The wallbang coming through, but unfortunately no damage done. As Major early on getting taken down to low HP with the CZ in hand. And the Terrorists, even though it was fast pistol round, they really are just taking their time into this first anti-eco.
Yeah, these Terrorists, they're just waiting these kills out. Zem's able to push inside with this Deagle, see if he's able to find anyone. But that is going to be Lord Farquaad getting the opening frag. Zem just looking in the wrong direction, watching those footsteps, but didn't hear Lord Farquaad coming from behind. Now that CZ, see if it can come into use. 13 HP, should get dropped pretty easily, but if he gets one or two frags here, that might be okay for their economy. But CZ only earning $100, really not going to be too worth it. See if maybe they can drop those AKs. There are three on that T side.
The Terrorist making their way towards this B bomb site. They really are just holding off, seeing if they can get any of the CTs to just slightly get aggressive to catch them off guard. As the Counter-Terrorists, they have sort of split up across the map. We have seen an aggressive push coming out towards Ivy. The Lord Firequad in the ramp is coming out the first point of contact. The Major trying to see what he can get done, but he can't do anything, as now the Terrorists are going to be able to get that bomb down. Exe finding one, but no more. There's going to be the scout player left in a 1-on-4. And the Terrorist making a very easy second round.
Losing that Galil isn't going to be too much of a problem for the economy other than losing maybe the armor. But Ronaldo's actually able to find one more. And that's an AK and a second kill. That's two AKs dropped. They're only going to be able to drag two AKs out of this round. But I don't even think Kingpin's going to be able to find one. So that's a great economy takedown from Ronaldo.
Just to be clear, guys, you'll notice... Oh, I need to imagine. You'll notice that it's... Ronaldo.
Oh,
there it is.
We'll just call him Teal.
Teal, yeah.
That's Teal.
Wait,
I keep calling him.
It is Teal. This is like a teal color.
Ish.
Okay. I see what you mean.
There you go, he's Teal now.
Perfect.
Now we can't see the game.
I'm just leaving the map open all the time. It's good.
Terrorists now making their way towards his A bomb, so I missed finding two with the AK, and it's all down to Teal left with the P250 in hand. Behind back blue, can't find anything. Shots coming off left, right, and center, and Blitz takes him down. So a very easy cleanup round coming out from the Terrorists, as now we're going to see the first buy round. And no AWP coming out, and what's interested me is the Terrorists, they're not upgrading their guns. So we've got a MAC-10 and an MP7 still in the hands of Baz and Lord Farquaad.
Surprisingly can be effective guns, especially if the CTs weren't to buy head armor, but They've decided to keep buying it instead of going for some extra grenades, and as you can see, the CTs are already out of grenades. The team pick works right to the site. Extra time goes for the second, gets it on Lord Farquaad. There's only now one left on the site. Mist finally finds that frag on the Xe, but that's a 2-for-1 trade. Zem tries to come in. Blitz chimes in and gets that opening. See if they can actually make their way into this bomb site and get the bomb down. The bomb is down now. Major works his way through uppers, gets the first kill. Try and find that second, but that player's behind the smoke. And that player up and now. That is going to be Blitz finding frag. Both players on those T-side are low. MP7 on Bass actually is able to get a kill. Angut finds the second with an MP7.
Righty there.
Wow. That's an interesting...
Actually, no, this is good. We're not on GoTV here.
Oh, yes.
Yeah,
we actually hear it
live. That's live. Even better.
That's live.
Woo!
Sort of deal.
Yeah. I don't know if they can hear that, so you just...
I don't think it gets
picked up. That's
why I
did it.
Yeah.
That's why I did it. It's very animalistic.
Counter-terrorists, they're just buying a little bit into this. A couple upgraded pistols, armor, head armor onto Major. But other than that, so far, the terrorists having a very good start into this matchup. An aggressive peek coming out from Xe as he finds the 1D. His teammate does fall, but actually he's going to get aggressive up to ramp, and he actually might catch his terrorist off guard. He does. He takes down Blitz, gets his hand on the AK, and he's not sure where these terrorists are as they're planting the bomb towards this big bomb site. Flash coming in over the top, and he does spray towards the wall. As APOC Dud coming in as well. So far, the terrorists, they're not making great presence. It's all down to Mist and King being left. The two AKs alive, and the terrorists are 2-on-3 situation. Bomb hasn't been planted and has dropped in the open. These two do need to get the synchronization on together. One of the CTs is spotted out, and King Big is going to be whiffing the initial spray, but finally is able to finish it off as it now goes back into a 2-on-2, and it's pretty much all up to Xe, the AK player in hand, until he really needs to be backing him up.
Teal needs to find this 1D instantly, but that player lower is just working his way behind, just watching for it, hoping that there's going to be a flank missed. Good Molotov, but there's no one going to be sitting there. Instead, it's going to be that player under, and now Mist goes for that jiggle peek. See if he can find the opening frag. He's just going to crouch peek out, finds the first opening, but Xe now takes that first headshot. That's going to be killed. Then goes for the fourth, sprays, misses it. Three bullets left. This is all down to King Big. And Ronaldo finally finds, or Teal finally finds that last 1D. Very good round from Xe.
Just a great round coming out from Kill Death, because it really just seemed that they didn't really have that much into it. A couple upgraded pistols, and the terrorists, they were just caught off guard by the aggressive play from the CTs coming up low ramp, and immediately it just took them off guard, and it was able to get the first round on the board for the counter-terrorists. But now it's going to be Bass with this AWP, so the first time, oh, and Zemp as well, so two AWPs coming out of the side of both of the teams, and Zemp, he's actually taking it to Brown Halls. He has spotted out one, but he misses a shot. You can't miss that. Lord Farquaad. Smokes are going to come down, but Major finds one, finds two with the M4 in hand. So immediately the counter-terrorist making work, but Mist able to try and equal it out, and Zemp, that's a great shot there.
Mist and King Big to try and bring it back. If they can find that frag onto Zemp, that might make their life a little bit easier, as he has all that utility to hold them off from that B bomb site, but he is soloing it on 17 HP. One AK bullet will end it all, but instead these players are just going to be working towards outside, bombing SL, King Big working towards a main, single flash, single Molotov. That could be useful towards backside and flush those players out. That flashbang, I don't know what he's going to do with that, but it's going to have to be important. APOC holding this Ivy angle, but no one's going to be coming there. That A main player now working his way out. SL giving that a little bit of a jiggle. That player heaven is going to be so important for this final round, or for the final part of this round. King Big walking all the way, hasn't been spotted yet, but that player upper has been killed now. Miss finds the frag, gets dropped down to 16. Green player gets taken down. APOC, that crucial player, is now dead. Two players solo, one bullet on each of them, but that utility will come into play. But he burns alive and it's already over.
Oh, wow!
That's a beautiful 2v4.
2v4 coming out from Mitch. That's just an incredible round. And they played it so well. They didn't get too aggressive. They didn't try and plant the bomb really early. They held their angles, tried to see where these CTs are hiding from, and they played it together. We saw the bomb being planted, and obviously one of the CTs getting aggressive to try to deny the bomb plant. And the terrorist, it was just King Big that was watching the angle. He knew that the CTs would get aggressive, and that's going to be the terrorist capitalizing on that. So, realistically, a fantastic round coming out from the terrorist, and an unusual Molotov there.
Well, it seems to be working well. They've just damaged all the players but Blitz, and Lord Farquaad sitting with that MP7, see if he can rack that money against the no-armored CTs, which would be very important to keep that AWP feeding on. he's going to be the first point of entry, but instead it's going to be Blitz finding that frag, surprisingly, getting dropped down to full HP, and then there's Lord Farquaad finally chiming in, gets that easy headshot against Zemp. I don't think the CTs have much of a chance, but as I say that, Major's able to find one onto Mist. I don't know where that was, but he's not going to be able to retrieve the gun anytime soon, but he gets that second one. Xe finds the third, and goes for the fourth. Now it's a 2v2. I don't know where this came from. A 1v1 left for KingBig. There's frags going left and right. It's going to be APOC. One versus one. Bombed on hand. Now they're spotted out. He's so low. See if you can find this one tap with this P250. Even with the buff... Oh, sorry, the nerf to it, it's still going to be able to one tap KingBig. What single smoke in hand. Bomb also in control, but he's going to work his way back. Full 40 seconds to go all the way back to the outer bomb site, and he's just going to do it. APOC might be able to find a gun, but no kit, no utility in hand. I don't know if he's going to be able to do this.
But he just hasn't realized that the players rotated off, and KingBig is going to be able to get the bomb side for free, but APOC is going to be able to pick up an AK. So it's definitely for a chance. He doesn't have any armor, but KingBig, he needs to get in the perfect scenario to be able to hold this angle down, a one-on-one situation. APOC Dud coming in from Z connected. The smoke is just going to deny him a bit of presence as it is, but KingBig just sitting at the bottom of the ladder. This could be a perfect position if APOC doesn't check, and KingBig is going to win that fight. So six rounds on the board from the terrorists, and so far, that was almost looking like the CTs were going to win that round with almost nothing.
So close, but bringing down four guns out of the five in a pistol round scenario without even any armor is just a bad situation. It's 1-6 right now, but the economy for the T's are still so terrible. They need to keep racking that up, but right now it's just going to be a double eco in the situation for the CTs. KingBig already working towards SL. I might find that player playing close, but now there's players out of T-Main, and that's Mist finding the opening frag yet again. KingBig trying to find something, but this Mist is going insane, getting the second kill on the sandwich guy, and Teal hasn't been spotted here. He's now an Olaf sitting behind those players, not able to find the first frag, whiffs the first spray, but finally finds it, then finds the second. Two wallbangs in this round, Mist is down, AK in hand, see if he can find even more frags, but he's going to be flanked in a second if he can't turn around in time, and that's going to be KingBig finally finishing off the round.
So far, it seems like the terrorists are really just getting control, and unfortunately for the CTs, they did have to double eco. So now they're going to be able to buy straight back into this Zemp. Once again on the AWP, and Bass is not aiming for it, but seven rounds on the board. It's not as if the terrorists are doing anything fancy, it's just that the CTs aren't able to hold off the presence so far.
Isn't exactly what I was thinking would come from the side of Killdeath, especially being the hyper-aggressive sort of players that they are. I would have expected them to start pushing Ivy, but instead now we've got three CTs working towards Ivy. That smoke is down, they're going to be working behind it. Plenty of utility still for the terrorists, but the CTs are running low, only a single smoke left. Those Molotovs might come in handy in a post-plant or after-plant sort of situation when they're trying to retake, but it's just going to be APOC trying to hold this angle, going to be jiggling it, see if he can spot the first player out, maybe find a frag. But I see him getting Molotov'd out, and they're just going to rush down Ivy, go piling out Team A with those last two players, and just split on this A site.
Well, it seems like the terrorists could be able to smoke off towards the back of Ivy and make their way on towards this A bomb site, but immediately it's actually going to be Zemp finding the first initial kill, KingBig as well with the AK in hand, and Zemp, he's caught off in this corner. He's able to take down Mist, but there's still a lot more to do in the smoke. He's going to deny the presence for the terrorists, but they're actually going to push straight through at KingBig on this entry, and he's just waiting in this smoke, just seeing if he can push forward, and he's not going to be indeed. So a 4-on-3 situation. Zemp, the Molotov isn't going to touch him. They have a very good idea where he is, and Lord Farquaad able to find one, and Zemp, a very nice kill, and Blitz and Major both finding kills, and it's all down to Blitz. 10 HP, a 1v2 situation. He doesn't have the bomb at his back as it's been dropped in the open. A lot more to do, but Major takes him down. So finally, the CTs, they're now able to find two rounds.
They're able to find that second round for themselves, but they weren't able to pick up Zemp's AWP, and that has been a crucial part of both those rounds. Him finding opening frags, that round finding three. X is going to be dropped down to a Mag 7, and APOC is onto a UMP, so that Mag 7 might be playing an SL, which is actually an okay spot for a Mag 7. And maybe for their economy gain, especially, look at Mist on a Tech 9, they rush down SL, they've got control already, and Xe's actually pushed Brownhall already, but that, I don't see what he's going to be able to do here.
If he can just hold a close angle, try and at least find one, that's $600 in the bank. So having a close situation with that Mag 7 could do a lot of damage, but he really needs to find the initial shots.
Well, he misses that first one. Actually, hits him, takes him down to 15. That could be crucial for these other guns, but now they've actually lost inner control. Major gonna be rotating here quick, making sure that they can't push early. Three players sitting towards white slash brown halls. They're now just playing around. I'm not sure exactly. They've dropped that Techno and back down to the Lord Farquaad to see if they can just entry off his death and trade one for one, which would be a perfect trade for them. Major peeking into it, finding that first frag, not even getting tagged, but that is only one player that was very low. There's still advantage for the terrorists. If they're able to find these frags, or even just the single entry onto the B-bomb site, that's a perfect after-plant situation for them.
Well, it's Major, the only one on the site. He needs his teammates to try and help him out, because he's not going to be able to hold this off. If he can find one kill and at least try and get the bomb to be dropped, that's the perfect scenario. Zemp coming in from Z-Connector to try and help him out, but 30 seconds left on the clock. He's actually going to rotate back in, and Major, he needs to hold this down. He finds one, and that's the bomb dropped. He needs to look for a second. He tries to find it. Zemp coming in as well. Missed, finally trading it out. And Zemp, he's got the perfect angle. He now finds two into the round, and it's all down to Mist. A one-on-three scenario, 15 seconds left. He needs to get something going. Tries to find one, but he's not going to be able to do it. So that's going to be Zemp taking him down with the CZ, the running CZ. And that's now going to be another round in the hands of the CTs.
But that is a reset for the terrorist. Maybe not a double eco, but that is a reset. If you look at their economy, they should be able to buy into this next one. The Deagles are in hand. See if they can find at least one or two kills, and, well, if they can find four like the CTs have been doing to them, they're going to force a reset very quickly and maybe even a double eco. This is very scary territory for their terrorists, but now that nade comes in, destroys them. Major doing work, Zemp finally finishing that off, but now these two players are in bottom SL, nade coming in, that's going to do a hell of a lot of damage. Spraying a bit too early, misses those frags. APOC able to find one to blitz, and those are the two players going towards Ivy, and that Molotov is just going to burn them out. Major finding all the last two frags. Beautiful split for those CTs.
Finally, the counter-terrorist finding some control as the terrorist, like you said before, it was able because the CTs were good, making the Ts continuously buy up again, the AK, the armor, and the utility. It's now affecting their economy, so they are going to be able to buy back into this, but they're not going to have the full utility that they want.
No, it's exactly what they need in this situation. The CTs, as you can see, they've just got full utility, but see if they can use it well. Zemp has actually been saving it a lot for afterplants. He hasn't used much at all except when the bomb goes down. But X is able to peek that, get the first kill on the King Digger. One for one trade. Major, last person here, isn't able to find anything, pulling out the gun. But now it's going to be back into a 3v3. All these players are low. These grenades are raining in, doing a hell of a lot of damage. Molotov onto the bomb site. Miss has to push. He's not going to be able to find a frag, but that's a beautiful Molotov. Bass not able to do anything, help his teammate. Miss gets killed, another frag grenade kill, and Bass is going to be the last person here right now. One versus three, sprayed through the smoke, just misses. Now, if he's able to find that diffuser, he might be able to win the round, but instead he's just spraying over his head. Zemp looking down at the perfect situation.
Well, so far, I mean, this is the kill death that we expected to play. The very puggy style on the CT, the rotations coming in very fast, and it seemed that they just didn't have their confidence level to start off. They had a terrible start, and the terrorists were just completely rolling them over, and now it seems that they found their footing. Zemp once again have that AWP in hand, and the terrorists, what a shaky buy, just upgraded pistols, some armor, and Xe, the first point of contact once again on this lower ramp, is going to catch off Mist, but he can't take the kill. Major chiming in with two, and that's going to be Xe trying to see if he can find any more, but Lord Farquaad's going to take him down with the Deagle, and Zemp, very nice AWP shot, the grenade coming in, as it's all down to Lord Farquaad left, and actually a very nice shot onto Major. The 1-on-3, he's not going to be able to find anything as Teal takes him down. And the gap is now only closed to one round.
Well, that ended that lead very quickly. That was a 7-1 to a 7-6. The confidence on those terrorists must be degrading very quickly. Bass not able to find anything for quite a few rounds now. We've had Major sitting at that top ramp doing a hell of a lot of damage. Now he's got an AWP in hand. Double AWP on those CTs, which is actually very viable on train. Let's just see how they be going. Major's been doing work with the M4, so I don't exactly know how this is going to go for them, but that spray.
Oh, almost so close
to killing Lord Farquaad. But really, I don't see the terrorists really getting much more. If the counter-terrorists can find another two rounds, or maybe just one more round, that does actually screw the economy for the terrorists on the final round. I don't know if they'll be able to buy an AWP again.
Well, so far, we haven't really seen an execute onto the outer bob site at all with the smokes, utility, all the flashes, and the molotovs. We just haven't seen it. It seems that they're really just trying to default, bait out the utility of the CTs, see if they can get some map control, some map presence, and then make their way towards the site. But it seems like they're constantly hitting B, and Xe is just... he's always sitting at the lower ramp or behind these spindles, that he's able to shut it down. And because he is able to take down one player and just stop the attack coming out from the terrace, it enables for the CTs to quickly rotate in from Z Connector.
And that is a perfect hold for them. Right now, the CTs are just getting their utility wasted, but they've still got that full kit of utility on Zemp. Like, he's been saving it every single time. He's been dying with the full kit of utility. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing in this situation, but now the terrorists are going to start making their way towards Ivy. Actually, Lord Farquaad out of SL already, able to find barely the first frag, down to 4 HP, one player is in that connector, down to 2, that grenade comes in finally, missed, shooting his own teammate, standing in that Molotov, nearly kills himself, goes down to 31. Player going all the way around, one person going through SL, old bomb SL, and that's Z connector getting taken down. King Big finding that. Bass is going to be hopefully watching for this player at SL. Instead, he's just going to walk straight through the smoke. No! Abe not able to find it. Blitz watches for it. That's perfect. Major now with the AWP in hand. This is a great round from the turrets. They're finally able to execute onto outers, but Major able to find one frag. If he can find two more, and doesn't even have to necessarily save the AWP, but that was so close. Wallbang's blitz down to 4-5 HP. And that's 8 rounds for the terrorists. I've been proven wrong, and I thought there was not going to be no more rounds for the terrorists.
There's still so much money on the side of the counter terrorists, but the terrorist side, they really haven't really been able to find anything on their gun rounds so far, and it seems like the CTs are really just taking control. And if they can play like this on the T side, Kill Def, they are up for a very good chance of taking this game just the way that they play.
Now the outers rush, Ivy Rush, which I was talking about before, gets shut down. Zemp gets taken down early. I'm not sure where that was, but these two players may be able to find one frag. The first frag not actually going in the favor of the CTs. APOC able to trade that out instantly. But now it's a 2v. APOC is low. He's not been doing too well this half so far, but Mage is behind. Is able to find that first frag onto Mist, but barely. And actually does that bomb control. Second onto Blitz. This is a very winnable round, as that bomb control is crucial, but that player, both players coming from inners, I don't think he'll expect this. Apparently just playing around and hoping that they would pick up the bomb themselves, leaving it completely alone.
I mean, he could even go for a big flank and make his way up to Pop Dog into showers, but it just depends on how the terrorists are going to play. They are playing together, making sure that you're not going to give the CTs those one-on-one engagements. It's all down to Bass and Lord Farquaad left, and they actually think that he's down Ivy. They're not quite sure where he is. A Major, he's got a perfect read onto this, a 1v2, as Major tries to come with the spray and he can't finish it off, as that was almost perfect positioning coming out from the man himself. But he's now, does he have the read that they're going to make their way up to Ivy? He has an idea that they're coming out from A-Main, and he's going to make his way towards Ivy. So this could be perfect positioning from Major, but he's making noise. They might be out of here and running, and I think Bass knows. Bass knows. The AWP lines him up, and Major gets taken down.
Major whiffing that spray. All he had to do was play like partial, wait for the frag, and wait, find that second. Dude. He had perfect positioning, read it so well, but instead the terrorists are going to be able to do it. What's happening?